Okay then, onwards and forwards with the forge for the soft start and inrush control unit for the 28 amp Big Dog. Okay, as you can see up in front of the camera there, Big Dog's come out to play in order to help me out with measuring the board up, the height of the board. Okay, how can I put this? Well, don't forget that the Big Dog's got some wheels, okay? So I couldn't have just gone to the reference on the technical document, which you can get for the Variacs, and just mark the height of that Variac on the board, plus a bit of extra height for the accessories, and then saw it in half, because you've all got to take into account the extra height given to that Variac by the wheels. Okay, so yeah, I've got a that's the return plug or coupler from the Variac going into an appliance inlet sat on top of the Big Dog there, and I'm just going to offer it up to the board. Okay, and then I'm going to put that mounting box just above it, and then when I'm happy with what I've got, I will then just take my little pencil, draw a little mark on the edge of the board, and then I should measure it up properly, get the jigsaw out, and sever it in half, sever that board in half. Now, what may very well dictate the height of the board is that backing board there. Okay, this white backing board, because what I'm going to do is the wiring for this inrush soft start control unit. I want to run all the cabling up the back of the board. Okay, given the size of the cabling, I don't want it all over the front of it. And so yes, it's going to be involving a lot of jigsaw action, just to saw the board in half, and then loads of hole saw action, so that I can run the cabling through to the back of the board between all the accessories. And then once I've done that, I'm going to cut that backing board down to size and fit it onto the back of the board. Okay, put a little smaller piece of wood right the way around the edge of the board, and then fix that backing board onto the back of the accessory board. Okay, let's have a look at that backing board. Well, as you can see, there's chunks missing out of it. Okay. Once again, another part of a wardrobe. Okay, don't forget, people. Okay, recycle and reuse. Look at this. So that edge is going to have to be trimmed right up. Okay. We've still got some staples hanging out here. So those are going to have to be removed. But overall, it's a nice piece of backing board, that. And, yeah, all I've got to do is to tidy that up a bit. Cut this piece to size, and then put it on the back of that board. Now, I've got it laid down that way, okay. If it can be used that way, that'll be fantastic, because that way it's wider than that board, okay. But if I stand it up the other way, I can sort of get away with it that way as well, but it's taller. Okay, let's do that. There we go, that's now taller. Okay. Once again though, it is wider than that board, so that'll be perfect as a backing board, whichever way round I choose to put it. Okay, but if that way up, as you can see down the bottom there, we've got all those holes and chunks missing. Okay, all of this, that. Okay, so that's the reason why I don't want the board that way up. But having said that though, if that's at the bottom like that and there is a few chunks missing out of it, it's not a big deal. Okay, this part up the other end, it was bigger than this, but it's obviously been torn. It was ripped off, basically. The wardrobe was destructively dismantled. Okay. And yeah, so I thought to myself, I'm having a load of that. It was the next neighbour's wardrobe, and well, I saw her chucking it all out in the garden one afternoon, and I thought to myself, right, I'm having some of that, because with that that board being that tall, you can see how tall that is. It's about as tall as what I am. Okay, what I was thinking is, in one video, maybe for another day, at another time, that board, think about how many electricity meters we could get on that, wire the whole lot up and get them all whacking round all at the same time. Okay, that would be some proper satisfaction on the load wheel action right there. But that's for, you know, it's another video for another day, if ever I do it, because I've got two of those. Okay, obviously speaking, you get two doors on a wardrobe, so I've got two of those. That one's going to get cut down for use as a soft start and inrush control unit on that big dog. Okay, and as I've got it positioned out at the minute, that's how I want it to be. And then I want to put some hooks in just there, sort of thing. And around the other side, and then round there I can put a big bungee strap around the Variac, round to the other side, and then that will, well, it'll be freestanding out in the garden whenever I'm doing sparks and pops and things, or funny wacky experiments. I can either choose to lie the board down next to the Variac, or can have it standing up. And to make sure it stands upright, I can put the bungee strap around the Variac. And there we go. So I'm going to offer those accessories up to that board now, waffle waffle, for 7 minutes, and I've had the battery light come on as well, so we're gonna have to go for another section on this. Okay, so let's offer those accessories up then. You can see your Variac there. Have I got a zoom on? No zoom, we don't need any. That Variac's big enough. So there's our, about there would you say? Okay, we've got no load of space there between the satisfaction dial and the underside of that coupler. Okay, there's the satisfaction dial there. There's the underside of that coupler. We've got no radius bends on that piece of cable. So about there, would you say? That would be nice, wouldn't it? I could lower it down a bit. Okay, don't forget we've got to take into account we've got to put that accessory box above that. And we got to take into account the height of that backing board as well, which is more or less going to dictate the height, the overall height of the soft start and inrush control unit board. Okay, so I'd say about there would do. That's quite nice about there. Okay, I'll get my hand in there for the satisfaction dial down there. There's the underside of that coupler with the cable coming out. I reckon that's quite nice about there. And so, around about there, if I move that camera up a bit, if I put that accessory box about there, I reckon that'll do it. So I'll take that away and put a pencil mark on the board. About there. I don't know if you can see that pencil mark. But, there it is. And I'll just draw a line straight the way across. Obviously nice and level. Get a spirit level and whatnot. Put it across there. Get the jigsaw out and slice the rest of that board right off. Okay. And then the other part, we can probably make a stand up for it or something. Put some electric meters on it and things. Okay. So, this is section one on this part. I'm going to have to do another section because I've had the battery light come on. Okay, so that's what's going to go next. Let me move that camera back. Okay then, let's have a little review of it then. Accessory board and backing board. Okay. That pencil mark I've put on there is only just underneath the height of the top of that backing board. Okay, there's the Variac all the way down there. Okay, And so, if I can find that pencil bark on there, probably not going to find it. Oh, there it is. Just there, there's the pencil bark. I'm going to cut right the way across there. And as you can see, it's only just underneath the height of that backing board. So I think we're going to do it, people. Okay, so the 10.5 minutes on this section, we'll go for a commercial break. And then we'll come back and you can see the progress on the board. But here we are then, back after the commercial break. And the board has been severed in half. Okay, there's a jigsaw there, and we've got some hearing protection going on because it was a bit noisy. And well, have a look at this lot. I don't know if you can see that, but well, there we are. I wasn't expecting that much sawdust to be created, so we're gonna have to get a little vacuum cleaner out and clean that lot up. I did put a rag underneath there on the floor, so that any sawdust that fell through would be, I'll just be able to pick the rag up and chuck it in the bin, you know, shake it out over the bin. There we are, and as you can see, bricks do have a certain use apart from being launched in washing machines. There we go, you can see all the sawdust on the rag down there. That was the idea, so that I'll just be able to pick the rag up and shake it out over the bin. But by the looks of things, I've got a bit of overshoot just there. And I made a glorious little pig's ear. That board there, the one that the jigsaw sat on, we can save it for other things. Maybe screw a few electric meters to it or something. Now, here comes the easy bit. Well, it sounds easy. I don't know if it's going to be or not. If that jigsaw went through that wardrobe door okay, it should go through the backing board okay. Right then, one backing board. All I've got to do now is lie our board down onto that, draw around it, and then cut it out basically. And I should be able to get a nice piece, a nice decent piece out of that. Okay. If you just bear with me a minute, I'll see if I can do that on camera. You just look at the big dog for now, and I'll do that. Okay, then we have a small technical problem. I'll turn the camera around. There's the backing board. There's our piece of board on there. And I've put that edge to that edge, but... oh dear. So I'm going to have to turn the backing board around the other way. Hopefully, it will then fit. Just people. Right then, let's turn it around. There you go. So we've got a bit of overhang at that end. Okay, and a smallest amount of overhang that end, and that'll only just fit. Okay. At the minute I've got that board raised up on those bricks, so there is a bit of warpage going on there. So what I will do is actually whip the bricks out, lie that down on the floor, draw around it, then raise it back up on the bricks again, get the old jiggy going, the old jigsaw there, saw all the way around it, and we've got a backing board for our soft start and inrush control unit for the 28 amp big dog. Okay, so that's what's coming up in a minute or two. Okay, I'll just draw around that and we'll go from there. Yep, I reckon that's it then. Okay, we're going to be getting on with that. Yeah, just stay there. And what I should do, I should do that, cut it out, and then we'll jump straight onto the next section, no messing about. And you can see the end result of that after 5 minutes. Okay, so don't move, it's coming up in a minute or two. Well, here we go, people. 35 minutes later after the last section. And have yourself a look at this. I never knew that cutting board produced that much sawdust. Okay. Yeah, there's a few bits of old backing board in there. I ain't having it. And there we go. So all the sawing is complete. I've had a whip round with the dustpan and the brush, as you can see up in front of the camera there. And also, because it is absolutely essential, it's cup of tea time again. Okay then, let's set that camera tripod up a bit and have a look at our end result then. There's our board, right there. Okay, and as you can see, it is almost the exact height of that cup, that kitchen worktop, which cup of tea time is sat on. And next to it, there's our backing board. Okay, there's a few holes in the bottom of it, just down the bottom there. There we go. But never mind, beggars can't be choosers. Recycle and reuse, people. Okay. Don't forget that. And if I'll just swing the camera around here a minute. There's our big dog. Okay. A pile of bricks. I'm not yet finished with bricks because we got to do some more drilling holes and hole saws and things in our board, because I'm going to be running the cables from the wiring accessories through the back of the board, hence that backing board. And there's our offcut there. There's the, you can see the handle for the wardrobe door. And just behind that, we've got that offcut of packing board. And as you can see, it's only slightly taller than that wardrobe door offcut. Okay. If it's a suitable width as well, then I've also got myself another backing board. And maybe at a later date, we can use that other section of wardrobe door or hanging electric meters on it or something. Okay. Yeah, I've also got, like I said in another section, I've got another complete wardrobe door. Okay, I don't know what I'm going to do with that, but that's another video for another day. I'm going to now get our board, lie it down on the kitchen floor there, and set the accessories upon it. Okay, so for the meanwhile, if you just have yourself a little look at the 28 amp big dog, I should get everything set up on the kitchen floor for you to have a look at. Just going to need that. Right, I'm almost done there, people. Switch. Okay then, right. That's some of the accessories set on the on our panel there. There it is. Okay. That's how I plan to set it out, and in that last section down the bottom there will be behind the Variac when it's stood upright. Okay. What can I say? Well, in another video on another day, I'm going to be start drilling some more holes out of that board, fixing those accessories on. Okay, I will position them a bit more carefully than that, because as you can see, they were sort of a bit over to the right a bit too much. Okay, I've just randomly chucked them on the board. I've also got two more switches and back boxes to put on, along with just a standard 13 amp wall socket outlet, metal clad one of course, to go on there, and that will be so I can plug something in there like a 3 kilowatt water heater, and that will be for the inrush control, okay, inrush control and soft start. What else can I say before I wrap this up then? Well, that's it really. You can see what I'm doing there. I'm going to set the accessories as you see them there. And then mark everything up, take all the accessories back off, and then start getting on drilling holes into that board and then passing the cabling up the back of the board. Okay. Yeah, so that's it. Okay, stay tuned and come back for another one on another day, people.